the dawn is breaking, a light shining through. You're barely waking, and I'm tangled up in you.
Even though Allison has been keeping it a secret from a lot of people in her family, we met on an online dating service. Of course, she found me because, you know, I was just so appealing, and some common interests in music and television. And
all the same stuff we like now, basically.
We started off very superficial and worked from there, but kind of on the spur of the moment one time, she was having a hard weekend and kind of hit it off. Well, we didn't hit it off right away.
We didn't hit it off.
That's a lie. I hit it off. I thought everything was going good, and I guess she wasn't really digging me.
He was very quiet, very nervous, and I thought that I could run all over him, basically. It's really what it came down to.
Somehow find you and I collide.
Yeah, because when I first saw pictures online, my first idea was, this can't be the person I'm talking to, because she was so beautiful, and the person I was talking to was so cool, and it was the real deal. And that first weekend, it was just, I don't know, I walked away from it really in love, I think, already. You know, even if I wasn't saying it to myself, I never looked back from that point on.
As soon as she walked in the door, we knew that Allison was right for Nikki. Had a hard spot to fill because Nikki has three brothers, and being a man's house, except for me, it was difficult for her at first, I think. And she made it seem very easy.
In time, somehow find you and
if you don't do the bar scene, you don't really meet friends, you don't really meet anybody. So I just talked to a lot of people online, and he just happened to be one of them. I didn't rule out the possibility that we could be together, but I also wasn't thinking that this was going to be my future husband someday either. So we went to just a local park, and we walked around for like 3 hours. And I could tell like something was weird about him, maybe a little nervous, or we were almost to the car, and he just stopped right in the middle of the park, and he basically said, I want to spend the rest of my life with you, and he got down on his knee. I don't even remember what he said, to be honest, because it was so fast, and I didn't know what was happening. He just got down on one knee, handed me the ring, and it was just so surreal. And we actually went to a Tool concert that night, so it was very fitting. It was just a very perfect day after the GRE score. It worked out very well.
Walked in and there was a guy sitting there. I thought he was very nice looking, seemed very nice, polite. And he reminded me of her dad, you know, tall, red hair. I like, he's a good guy. I think he'll make Allison very, very happy.
Or sell.
All right, fellas, the knot is tied. Allison and Nick are newlywed.
You're from Queens. You got a love tattoo. You love porn. She's from Cleveland. Boy, you are marrying upward.
Is he in for a world of hurt with me?
I don't know.
We probably wish Allison, you know, a little more. We're worried about Allison. She's got to put up with Nick.
We know what's on.
I think he's in for a long haul. I feel sorry for you, Nick.
Allison, what are you thinking? You're from Cleveland. You're trading in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame to go listen to Korn for the rest of your life with the King of Queens.
Joke, huh?
Are you kidding me?
You, woman, are a saint. I've lived with Nick before. I've heard Snot's greatest hits at volume 11. I've seen his athletic prowess on the field. Your kids are in trouble. He was right. You are the person that he's made
for.
You are the person that he's completed his life. The person that gives him more joy than that Korn reunion tour. Best of luck to you.
Just being with Allison, I mean, she's just the person that makes you feel comfortable being you. And that's not just with me, that's just all of my friends. I mean, they just hit it off with her right away because she just has this special thing about her that she just makes you feel okay being you. And from the moment we were together, even before we became serious, you know, I never felt like I had to wonder about her, never doubted her intentions, always felt like I was in good hands, and I'd never felt like that before. And it's a really nice feeling. You know, I've never felt comfortable being with myself with anyone else before.
I think it's more for me, the fact that I'm like a crazy person, and he understands me, and he listens when I talk, actually, and he actually understands what I'm saying when I'm talking to him, so.
I translate.
Yeah, he's a good translator for me, and he understands what I'm thinking all the time, and we just always, our communication is so good. We've never questioned our communication at all, and he's probably the only person I've ever been able to communicate with the way that we do, and just understand each other, and it just works. It just clicks, it just works.
Don't sweat the small stuff. It's a long and happy life. For the rest of your life.
Being in a marriage, is, no matter how bad it is, just be honest with each other. Honesty is the key.
You know, certainly we're wishing them best wishes on their new venture. We're very excited about it.
I love him to death, and I cannot wait to spend the rest of my life with him and have children and go through the hardships and good times and basically everything that you could possibly think of. He's the person that I want to do all that stuff with.
But, you know, I think it's important that she knows that how much she means to me. And even in my worst times, when it may seem that I'm consumed with everything else in my life, nothing ever matters to me as much as she does. So no matter what it may be looking like from the outside, whether I'm consumed with work or just life in general, I never forget that she's number one to me. And, you know, and I just can't wait to spend the rest of my life with her.
If I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?